The temporal bone is seen right here. This is your temporal bone. Now, when we start looking at the landmarks, we'll start with this structure here, which is called the zygomatic arch. It's actually comprised of the temporal bone and this bone, which is the zygomatic bone. So the zygomatic arch runs from right here, where it comes off the temporal bone, up into this area, which is the zygomatic bone. The temporal bone is going to have this protrusion, which is called the zygomatic process. So to go up to where this suture is right here, this is the zygomatic process of the temporal bone. On the other side of the suture, or the more anterior side of the suture, we're now on the zygomatic bone. This area right here that's coming off the zygomatic bone is called the temporal process of the zygomatic bone. Together, the zygomatic process and the temporal process, together they make the zygomatic arch. Now, from the same view here, we can see this bump protruding. This bump is actually just behind your ear. You can actually feel it if you go just behind your ear. It's called the mastoid process. The mastoid process is filled with cells that are called the mastoid air cells. So they're found within it. This opening you see, that's what leads into your inner ear. That opening is called the external acoustic meatus, or you can call it the external auditory meatus. And then this whole region right here encompasses both the temporal bone right here, and this is part of your jaw, or the mandible. So where the temporal bone and mandible come together is called your temporal mandibular joint. Just anterior or in front of that is this little tiny bump here. That small bump is called the articular tubercle. Articular because just in front of where the mandible articulates. So now if we move this a little bit and take the jaw out, you can see that this is where the jaw would have been located, this indent. That indent is called the mandibular fossa. So that indent is the mandibular fossa. And from this view, there's a few other things we can see now of the temporal bone. So we're on an inferior view. We can see this nice spike right here. It's called the styloid process. If we go just between, so there's a little tiny hole right there. That hole is between the mastoid process and the styloid process. That's called the stylomastoid foramen. The stylomastoid foramen. Now there's a few other small holes we can see down here. Just coming from the foramen magnum, which is on the occipital bone and the occipital condyles, go a little more lateral, you can see this indent right here. That is your carotid foramen. Now, typically it should go right through, but this mold doesn't have it going through. So that's the carotid foramen. Just posterior to that back here, this opening is your jugular foramen. So we have the carotid foramen and the jugular foramen. Again, this was the styloid process, stylomastoid foramen, mastoid process. The indent where the jaw should articulate is the mandibular fossa. If we open up the skull, because remember it's three-dimensional, so you open it up, this internal portion is still part. So this internal portion right here is still part of the temporal bone. And this opening right there, that opening is the internal auditory meatus, or internal acoustic meatus. There's more than one term for it. So that's basically where the nerves from your inner ear exit to come to your brain. The internal acoustic meatus, and the outside has the external acoustic meatus. So your temporal bone. can see it from the lateral view and then from the inferior view.